Hey guys, Zizek here. I know it's been, checks notes, over a year since I've made a video. I apologize. I feel like I say that a lot every time I start these videos, but I'm not going to get into that in this video. I have so much to do. This is hopefully the official start of me coming back more regularly to YouTube. I'm not going to try and set a schedule or anything like that because I know me. But I'm definitely going to try and make videos as much as I can because we have so much stuff coming out this year in terms of card games and cool stuff. Obviously the big one for me is Battle Spirits. I'm so excited this is now back, but we've also got to take a look at Grand Archive, Vanquishers, Primal. There's like six other TCGs from Kickstarter that I've already forgotten about. There's so much stuff coming out this year and I'm so excited. But first, I just wanted to give... So Battle Spirits Saga had its first launch event in Las Vegas over the weekend. As you can see, I was one of the judges for the event. So if you were there, you most likely saw me running around somewhere. It was insane. I forget the total number of players. I think it was almost 500 players. It was a crazy three-day event for you guys, a five-day event for me, for setting up and tearing down everything. I'm super, super thankful for Bondi and PlayTCG for letting me come judge. I had so much fun, even though I'm filming this on Thursday night. I got back on Monday night. I've just been dead that entire time recovering from it. But, so I haven't opened any of my stuff yet, so that's why I'm making this video, because I want to open my stuff. I'm so excited to see this game. Before we get into the booster box though, I just want to really quick go into some of the stuff we got for judges. We got the participation prizes that all you guys got for playing. So we got a life counter. These are actually like, I wouldn't say plastic, but they're kind of a laminated cardboard. And these are to go on your playmat to hold your five cores to designate your life. And it has the sixth one just in case you gain life. These are really nice. I was really excited about getting one of these. It'd be nice if it was plastic, but I don't think it's going to be any trouble anytime soon. So everyone got one of those. And then funny story about these. So, if you've been following this event, you'll know that there was two different kinds of core cases you could get at the event. There was a participation one, and then a top 32 one, one that only the top 32 players got. The participation one had the Battle Spirits Saga blue logo that you can see there, and the top 32 had this cool BSS, like, the card back logo. Apparently, I don't know where, somewhere, somehow, something got swapped, and those got reversed. So it turns out that everybody got the special fancy BSS logo one, and then the top 32 players got the regular Battle Spirits logo cases. I think I still got the white cores and everything, but yeah, everyone got the cool BSS logo one, which is cool. And this is just holding my cores. I have so much more than this. One of the things I want to do, I know it's stupid, but honestly the cores is what got me into this game because they're just so pretty and I love tactile things, especially when it comes to card games. I want to get some kind of like treasure chest or jar or something, and every time I buy a Battle Spirits product I'm just going to pour it into it, so I just have, you know, after like a year of playing or something, I'm just going to have this giant box of just thousands of cores and like Scrooge McDuck it, I don't know. But for anyone that hasn't seen them, this is the English cores here. They are different than the Japanese cores. You can probably see back there, I actually have some Japanese cards that I bought just to compare. And these are the Japanese cores. You can see they're flat. And they're kind of a lighter blue. These are the English cores. They're almost like a 12-sided die. They're more than that, but they're kind of, you know, more round. You can see this is flat, and these are definitely not. So, originally I was kind of bummed they were changing it because I love these cores, I just love how they look on the cards. But then as I started playing more, I realized that I do like these more to actually play with because they are much easier to actually pick up and move around than the flat cores. Did I just throw that into my core case and now it's lost forever? Oh, nope, oh, I got it, there we go. They're much easier to pick up and move around than the actual Japanese cores, I think. But because they are more round, if you exhaust your card, you know, tap it to swing just a little too fast, the cores just go rolling off. So that's kind of the downside of these as well. So there's the cores. And then here is the special Soul Core. So a cool thing about this game is, since it's not just a direct translation of Battle Spirits, we're actually getting rule changes, card reworks, and basically we get to cherry pick the cards that go in our set, so we get all of the cool mechanics basically out of the gate. So this is something that came much later into Battle Spirits in Japan. It's called the Soul Core. Everyone gets one special Soul Core, you only ever have one, and basically certain cards do certain things with your Soul Core specifically. So you can see it's a little bit bigger than regular cores, and it has this cool glittery sparkle silver stuff inside. And I'm pretty sure this one's like a straight up D12. But then we have, to compare, we have the Japanese Soul Cores, which I thought, again, I would like more. Because for some reason, I thought these were metal. This was like a big, heavy, like, die-cast metal thing. It's still plastic, it just has shiny paint on it, essentially. But it's really, I don't know if you'd see, but it's really dull. Like, it's not bright. And this one just almost seems like it glows. So, I kind of, like, all in all, I do like the Battle Spirits Saga cores better than the Japanese cores. Okay, so everyone got those for participating, and everyone also got these event packs. I'm not 100% sure where these are going to be, like, distributed at. I know there's been a couple ways to get them so far, but these are 12 different cards, and they're mainly commons and uncommons, maybe rares, from the from this first set, but they have a cool foil pattern based on the color. Each color has its own foil pattern. Everyone got, I believe, 3 or 4 of these, and then the more you won, the more you got, basically. We got them as judges too, so I'm not going to open up all of them on camera, but I am just going to open this up, because I haven't opened any of these yet, and just show you what these event cards look like. And there we go. This is Freestall, little koala bear for the yellow color. This guy is an absolute staple. If you play the 2-cost spirit decks for yellow, he's a 4-of automatically. But you can see these event cards, they're foil, but then they have a special foil just for the colors. So yellow has these angel feathers all around it. And then just the normal backs. The backs are beautiful, of course. I was kind of bummed that this isn't textured, like Buddy Fight cards. I still think Buddy Fight cards have the best card backs of any card game. I was kind of hoping this would be like the textured, kind of rough material, you know, but it's just matte. But it does have the cool picked out, like, spot treatment, UV spot treatment, whatever that's called. Yeah, it looks good. So there's Freestall. And then just a couple other things to show off before I get started. This is one of the demo deck cards. This is the foil Seagorn that you get for playing. And I actually had Mike Elliott, the original designer of Battle Spirits and Duel Masters and Yo-K Watch TCG and like 15 other TCGs. He was actually there. It was so awesome to meet him. I got to talk to him for a little bit, and he signed my Seagorn there. So that's my signed Mike Elliott card. And then this one I'm really excited about. So if you've been following Battle Spirits at all, you've probably seen some of like the like Twitter contests and different things they're doing to give away test print cards. So I don't think we have official numbers on these test print cards or anything, but I'm pretty sure, again, not 100% certain, but they're all one of one. So there's only like one of each kind of test print card made. All of us judges got to get one at the end of judging everything because it was such a crazy event. So this is my potentially one of one judge test print card, and it's Blinding Thorn. So this is test print, so these basically can't say anything for the cost and the effect anything. It's just a test of the actual print quality and the foil and the texture. So you can see this has a cool, like, what is that called? Like, diamondback texture, I guess. And it has, I want to say that's a blue card. It might be a white card, or white spirit. Yeah, that is my test print card. Super excited I got that. Okay, stalled enough. I'm going to open this box. I got multiple boxes. I'm not going to say how many. I also may have a box pre-ordered too that's coming, so we'll see. I don't know if we'll open starter decks on camera or not. If you guys want to see those really bad, just let me know. But I have to get into this booster box because it's been sitting here for almost a week now, taunting me, and I just haven't had the time to open it, so let's get this open. Alright, plastic is off. These boxes have 24 packs, a box topper, and 12 cards in each pack. There you go, and there's one of four box toppers you can get, and I got the red one. This is Divine Halberd Dragon Arc. I'm sorry, my lighting is terrible. I just want to get these open, so I just did what I could. This is a red, 3-cost, 2-reduction Star Dragon Spirit. Levels 1, 2, and 3, neither player's life can be reduced by an attack from a spirit that has 2,000 or lower BP. So basically, this just stops rush decks. And then when this spirit attacks, select one of your opponent's spirits 2,000 BP or less and destroy it. Pretty cool. Oh, there's four box toppers, one for each color. I honestly only know what this one is because it says it right there in the box. I don't know what the other three are. But that's not important. We have packs. Oh, so many packs. All right. I'm not going to read all these cards, I'm just going to look at the rares and foils. Because we have a lot to get through, and I want to get through this. So, here's our booster pack, Dawn of History is his first set. That's Madook there, basically the purple, like, general. There's 272 types of cards in this set. Normal and holo versions of common, normal and holo versions of uncommon, normal and holo versions of rare. 12 X-rares, which are kind of like the big cards. 11 special rares, which are alt art versions of cards in the set, which are all beautiful. And then the Saga rare, which is Mr. Seagworm Nova right there. I saw a bunch of them at the event. Like, I swear, almost every match that I walked by had one on the field, so I hope I get one of those, obviously, but I'm just excited to get packs open, so let's go. Oh, and did I mention Bandai? Thank you for keeping the pull tab. That's... You already win. Alright, let's just go through these. Dynaman Tyranoid, Phobos Dragon, Automatic Gunner, Magic Swordsman Dragonaga, Dark Matter, Fairy Blacksmith, Rocket City. This was a fun card. This caused a lot of questions and pain for the judges. Just read the FAQ on it. Sage Beast Iberex. Fierce Gorer Horn Grizzly. So also, I've barely seen any of these cards. I only knew like the problematic ones that we'd need to know for rolling and everything, so almost all these cards are gonna be new to me too. Starblessed Draw, there we go. That's a four of in every deck, essentially. Royal Potion is our rare. Very nice. And then our foil is a common. Fairy Flautist. I think that's how you say that. And then on the back we get a core card. So this is a cool thing that I want to say is exclusive to Battle Spirit Saga. This was not in the Japanese game. If you don't want to use the plastic cores, you can use these core cards instead and basically play like One Piece, where you attach these, you know, underneath the card, and these are your cores instead of little plastic gems. And you can use the back to signify an amount of cores in places where it's difficult to see. Yeah. I think it's cool. We actually had a lot of players at the event using these instead of core cards, instead of cores, and I could definitely see both ways. I'm a sucker for shiny click-clack things, so I like the cores, but I will still probably sleeve up some of these to keep with some decks, just in case, and go back and forth. Alright, next pack, we have Dual Gun, I believe is his name. The big scary white Gundam thing. Speaking of, if you guys didn't see, in set 2, we are getting official collaboration cards for Gundam. So, obviously super excited about that. Alright, we got everyone's favorite mascot, Pantin. Oviraptodon. Imperador. Scythejaw. Horned Penguin, that's adorable. Gleam of Hope. Skeleviper. Head Snow Librarian Saga. Alright. Volcanic Canyon, another really, really good card almost in every deck. Netherworld Depths, a card that was in every deck that has purple. And then our rare is Divine Mars Dragon Ares Dragoon. Yeah, this is definitely a Japanese game with all the giant names. Really good red card. And then our shiny is a uncommon Infinity Mothership. That's actually pretty cool. And then we got a Soul Core Core card. Alright, next pack is, that is Archangel Michaela. If you guys saw pictures or videos of the event, you saw that we actually had a cosplayer there cosplaying her, and she was amazing looking. She had giant wings. She was bumping into everything. I felt bad. But all three of her cosplayers were amazing. If you guys haven't seen them, go look them up. Rainbow Angel. Okay, we're just going to start going through these because I just want to get through this. To the uncommons. And, oh, so that's an uncommon to our foil, which is a common. So that means something's behind this? No. Right. So I heard this, and I wasn't sure if it was true or not, but I guess it is. You can actually get a pack with no rares in it. Because that was all uncommons and then a foil common. I really hope that is just some mistake for this first set. Because you do get a foil in every pack, but foils can be common, uncommon, or rare. And the rare cards are actually very important. So I hope that's fixed in coming sets. I don't know if it's intentional or not, but it just feels kind of crappy to open a pack and not even get a rare inside, you know? Feels like the old days of Yu-Gi-Oh! When they just had the silver text rares and you could just open like 10 packs and get nothing, literally. Alright, let's go through these. Mr. Pintan. Rotting Swamp, also good. Oh my god, look at them. White Hole Dragon, there's Infinity Mothership. There's our rare Pandemonium. Pandemium, there we go, of the Dark World 7. One of the big scary Dark 7 guys. And then a foil common, Magic Swordsman Dragonaga. Alright. Another Madook pack. Alright, got a Bone Scout, Flying Turtle, Gunner, Nebula Dragon, Suppression. Suppression was a good card. Flamefish, Flying Arc, Twilight Dragon Rider, Flavum. I've never seen that card. This would probably look amazing in foil with all that picked out. Fortress Metropolis, Now Man City? White's like this ice wasteland with like giant cyberpunky cities with these like giant mecha elephant cities and ice princesses. I love white. That's a cathedral, that's a good card. Another rare, Sky Dragon Lord Platinum. And then a foil rare, Centaurosaurus. Very cool. Nothing crazy yet. Plenty of packs to go through. Satellite Falcon, Werewolf. I swear I haven't seen most of these cards. Bearded Eagle, that's a robot. Exhaust Nexus was another staple card. He's scary. Librarian, Spider Demon, Counter Sword, another awesome card. Probably going in my deck. Ooh, and we got a rare, Divine Flower Queen Marigold. Never seen it. Alright, and then our foil is a rare, Raging Dino Dirano Rex. I kind of want to make a dino deck, because you guys know me, and red, and fire, and dinosaurs, and it's all my favorite things. Speaking of, Dino Man. Benton. And that's an uncommon. The bird uncommon. Got a rare Flame Emperor Agniffin. Pretty cool. And then, hey, we were just talking about him. And I was correct. That looks amazing in foil. All the gold and the gems picked out. Oh man, that's cool. I'm really happy we got that in foil. That's exactly what I wanted. And before anyone starts asking in the comments, I have no idea what ratios are. Ragnar Guard. Camelot Knight, Spear Angel. There's our rare King Snake Quetzalcoatl. It's a very pretty card for a purple card. And then our rare, or our foil, is a common Dark Lancer Cavalier. Very cool. There is Mr. Siegworm Nova. Have we had a pack with him in on it? Him yet? If we have, I didn't even notice it, so that means this pack is gonna be good. There's a new Ice Maid. Cornered Flame Rat. Alright. Mechanic Break is a good card. And then this is our rare Fortress God Knight Odin type. Can you tell why I like the white cards too? Because they're literally just Gundams. And then our foil is a uncommon Fierce Gorer Horn Grizzly. Oh! Okay, so apparently if you get a special rare, you get a foil as well. Oh my god. This is the alt art special rare for Star Blessed Draw. And my lighting and camera just absolutely will not give this justice. Oh my god, that is gorgeous. All of that, it's hard to tell, but all that etching is actually spiraling into the black hole there. So it's actually all curved and spiraled into it. Let's see if we can get closer. There we go. Wow. Alright, well, I guess you can go back here with the shiny card. So our first hit, as the kids say. Turtle. Sorry, I'm looking at the card, not the camera. Court Theft was another really good card. Bithon, Burst Venom. Here we go. Absolute Ice Shield. This card. This card is literally... When people say cards are staples, sometimes they're over-exaggerating. This card is literally four of in every single deck. Every single deck. like, out of the 500 deck lists, there was maybe just a handful of decks that didn't run this, no matter what color you run. This isn't like Vanguard or something like that, where you have to stay in your color. You can splash whatever you want, you just won't get the cost reduction, so... Yeah, this is a good card to have. This is a 4 of in every single deck. I'm not joking. For those of you who don't know, burst cards just hit face down, and then when something happens in the red here, it activates, flips up, and does something. For this one, the burst condition is when you lose life. So when you take a core from your life and put it into your reserve, you flip this over, place a core from your reserve into your life. Then you pay this card's cost to activate its flash effect. So that core you just lost for your life, put it right back up in your life, and then you can pay 4 to end the battle step. So, not only do you remain at the same life, you then stop the battle and just come back to your turn. It's a ridiculous card. It's a staple in every single deck. Fun FAQ for you guys out there. If you're at 1 life, and you try to use this burst, you lose immediately. I'd explain that a lot. As soon as you're down to 0 life, it doesn't matter if we're in the middle of an effect resolving, you lose the game. So, fun pro tip for you. And then we got a foil rare, Mecha Beast Fortress Naumengard. the giant awesome mega elephants. Really just looks like the Mastodon Zord, you know? You know where I come from? That was a good open. That was a nice clean open, so please let there be something good in here. I'm already running out of room. Cute fairy, mech, dinosaur, mech, creepy, dragon, cute, land, librarian, land. Ooh, we got a foil royal potion. It's really good. This is obviously a staple in the two-cost spirit, yellow spirit deck. I don't think it's going to be... It's not a whole lot right now, but I think this is one of those cards that's only going to get better and go up over time. And we have our X-Rare. Took me a second. This is our first X-Rare. There are 12 X-Rares in this set. Dinosaur Harrier Turbo Rex. So if you can't tell, I'm stuck between red and white on what to play. And this is exactly why I even consider white. Giant robot dinosaur, come on. I don't remember ever really seeing this played at the event, but I definitely want to use it because, I mean, robot dinosaur, how can I not use this? Put that in the hits pile. Alright, this is our last pack on the left side. Boa Trictor, Hippocampo, Nebula Dragon, Mech, Creepy Mech, Bird, Dragon, Depressing. There's a rare, so that's our first double rare, I believe. Oh no, sorry, this is our promo. This is a promo that you got. Nice. And then a foil common Bullet Ray. I just said how beautiful all the cards are in this game yet, by the way. These foils are gorgeous, and all the art in this set is gorgeous. Alright, we're officially halfway done. We have 12 more packs to go. We're gonna fly through these because it is getting late, and I want to go to bed. Ice Maiden, Snake, Angel, Knight, Dinosaur, Place, cute, dinosaur, something, dinosaur. A rare is Valkyrie Mist. That looked like Gardevoir for a second, like the future paradox Gardevoir. I can't remember what it's called. All right, and then our rare or foil is, oh no, Vajranosaurus. And just gonna put that away. Alright. Ooh, good open. I'm really bad at spoiling the cards. Armored Beast Gullen Bursty. Sure. Cute imp. That is a terrifying elk? I don't know. Dinosaur, snake, creepy. Should be our... Oh, this is our foil. So Volcanic Canyon foil, that's good. This is a really sought-after card. Basically, you draw an additional card, then after you draw, discard a card, so it's more draw. All the drawing cards seem to be in red so far. I'm sure blue's gonna have some whenever blue comes out in the next set, but red has a lot of draw. Ooh, there we go. Alright, this is our next X-Rare. This is a red... Spirit, Storm Beast, Emperor, Thunder, Leon. That is pretty cool. God, look at the eye picked out in foil there. See it? Oh, that's awesome. Okay, so that's two X-Rares so far in an alt art. I'm more than halfway through the box. So that has to mean all the stuff's on this side, right? Hopefully. First Stars Are Born. I thought this would be played more, but it really wasn't. Blizzard, Depth, Python. There's a rare Phantom Beast King Lean. And a foil Exhaust Nexus. Also really nice, because again, this is, if you played yellow, you played this. Sweet. Alright, Angel, that's new. That's an awesome looking card, okay. Aqua Knife, this is one of my favorite cards. Turtle, Land, Penguin, Suppression, Creepy, Cute. The Starblast Draw, and our uncommon, or foil. Oh wait, so we got a foil. So that means something behind is good, right? Is that the pattern here? We got a foil uncommon, Dark Knight Palamedes. And we did! This is another X-Rare, this is a yellow Wonderland Alice. This is literally Alice from Wonderland, if you couldn't tell. Very, very pretty card, the foil is amazing on it. Really got to get a better setup for my lights, because this, like I said, the lighting in this camera does not do this justice. Alright, come on, Michaela. Alright, come on, something good, please. Surprisingly, I haven't seen a lot of doubles so far, and the only doubles I've seen are like actual like spell cards or magic cards that I want, so that's nice to see at least. A rare Dark Bishop Baculus. Yep. And then our foil is Rotting Swamp. Very nice. I punched the camera. Alright, we got a Bearded Eagle. Man, I swear, like, it's... Every time we open a pack, there's at least one new card in it that I haven't seen before. It's crazy. Uncommon, whoop, that's a spoiler. Uncommon, and then yeah, our foil is Absolute Ice Shield, which is really good. You really want these in foil, you really want the alt art, but foil is really good too. I'm glad to have that. And then got another X-Rare. This is the purple. I keep wanting to say black, it's purple. Dread Knight Nemesis. Oh, it's really cool. The background's kind of like out of focus, if that makes sense. So he's just like the one in focus with the outline around him in foil. Oh, that's awesome. All right, so that's what, 1, 2, 3, 4 X rares and an alt art. Hopefully that's not everything, but I have no idea. Dragon. See, every pack has a new card. Stream Otter. Just a robot otter. Alright. This is an uncommon. That looks like something out of Warhammer or something, right? God, I love the art in this. More uncommons. This is a rare. Beldegor of the Dark World 7. He's apparently important. A foil Boa Trictor. Alright, we're down to 5 packs. Is there a random Saga Rare hiding in here? Or another alt art or something, please? We also haven't seen Buffalong Bill. I really want to get one of those. Counter Sword. Here's our rare Raging Dino Dyranorex. And our foil is Scythe Jaw. Common. If you guys haven't seen or don't know who ProZD is, he's an hilarious, amazing YouTuber. I've been following him for years. Hit my camera again. Battle Spirits actually sponsored him to do a couple skits and sent him some cool stuff. And he's actually going to have his own cards at the early Doctor stores. Sadly, here in Austin, there is no early doctor stores anymore anywhere around me. So hopefully I can get to Dallas and play in one of the ones there to get those cards, because that's just hilarious. Falcon. Breath. Here we go. Heavenblade Dragon Ryute. This was another really, really good card in a lot of sideboards from what I could see. And then Foil Tank. Curiosity. Sure. Alright, three packs. Let's get one more good thing. Come on. Hippocamp. Maybe the Dragon. Nice Maiden. That thing. Tank. Oh. Rare. Foil rare. So that means... yeah. So we got another X-Rare. Armored Dragon Ship Enterprise. This is another very, very staple card. Mainly because it has armor purple. It has armor red, purple, and white. Which essentially means this card cannot be touched by anything that's red, purple, or white. And then when it's level 3, all your spirits gain armor red, purple, or white. Yeah. Very good card. And a lot of sideboards as well, just to throw in there just in case. Awesome. So, I think that's 5, 6 X-Rares? I want to remember hearing that you get 2 Alt Arts, or 2 Special Rares, basically, or like 1 Saga Rare, so we'll see. Bone Scout. Car Bulk. How are we still seeing new cards? This is insane. Also, card quality is amazing on these. They are thick, and I love it. Uncommon. Got a foil common. And that's it. We had no rare in that pack. Alright. Last pack. Come on. Something good, please. Something good. Alright. Starting off good. Iguana Knife. Beam of Hope. Flame Fish. Tank. I think we have one more card, so there's something good behind this. Okay, we got a foil. Uncommon. White Hole Dragon. Very cool looking. We got another X-Rare. Nice. This is Infernal King Cursed Dragon. Very good purple card. Awesome. Okay. So that is... yep, that is all our packs. So let's do what all the cool YouTubers do and recap the hits. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 X-Rares. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, 6 X-Rares. White, purple, yellow, red, white, purple. And then an alt art, Starblessed Draw. So I wonder if these are 1 a box? I thought they were 2 a box, but I guess not. I guess maybe you can just get unlucky, which of course I will. So that's awesome. Okay. This video has gone on way too long. I'm so excited about this. I will absolutely be having more videos soon for all kinds of stuff, more Battle Spirits, one of the other 14 card games coming out this year. I'm so excited. I'm so excited for all these card games. I'm so excited to get back into this. Thank you guys if you're still watching, for sticking around, especially all this time, you know, just a year in between videos. if you guys have questions or comments, let me know below. If you guys have anything you want to see me do, please let me know too, and I'll try to do as much as I can. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you again, Bandai and PlayTCG, for sending me to Vegas. And that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a nice day.